Woodman is next on your hit list. Appropriately, it takes place in the woods. You'll encounter bats and purple rabbits that throw carrots. Interesting. You'll head underground and run into three of these giant blue dogs consecutively. They look a lot like a blue version of your future sidekick, Rush, but these guys are called hot dogs due to their fire-breathing ability. Metal Blade works well against them. It's also useful up here on this wooden tightrope against these monkeys that hang from below and the birds that drop eggs from above. If the egg hits the ground before you shoot it, it'll hatch an annoying flock of baby birds, slice those little feathered fucks apart. The rabbits return for a few go-arounds indoors. Use the metal blades to hit them when they're downhill like this. Right at the home stretch, you'll find yourself running in the wrong direction of a stampede of wild ostriches. They'll jump right over you as long as you keep running. Woodman will attack you with his feared arsenal of deadly leaves. It starts out as an impenetrable barricade that circles him while he casts small leaves into the sky. Then he fires the shield at you and the others fall in a line. Jump over the shield and use the metal blades while standing as far left as possible to avoid the falling leaves. Every time he throws the shield, he hops a few steps closer to you, making it harder to jump the shield. After cutting this robotic tree down to size, you'll get the leaf shield. It barricades you with leaves if you stand still, but as you start running, you'll fire it. It's not so great as a weapon, and it's not very good as a shield either. But it does prove useful in a few spots, just not that often. Next up is Airman Stage. In between the platforms at the beginning are these huge red-faced things with horns that raise and lower while miniature versions of itself fly out of its ears. The giant face is really just a platform, but the horns hurt you. So wait for them to go down when jumping to and from the platforms and keep your eye on the little guys coming from both sides. Take out these lightning bolt throwers and hop on their leftover cloud platform. You'll do battle with a few of these like this from the cloud. It can get pretty tricky in one part where your patterns overlap and the platforms disappear into the clouds. Jump on it when it comes back into full view, but don't wait too long or you won't be able to reach. Later on, you'll run into Airman's cousin. He blows. Literally. Just keep running and chuck the metal blades at him. The regular arm cannon works fine on him, but the blades do better damage to dropping bird eggs. Down the stretch, you'll find some more of these bird bastards. The leaf shield works pretty well against them. Keep the leaf shield equipped when you get to Airman. He'll fire a bunch of tornadoes at you with a different pattern each time, before leaping across the room and attacking the same way from the other side. The air keeps you from running too freely, but all you'll need is two shots with the leaf shield and he's done for. You'll get item 2, and you'll get the air shooter, which fires 3 tornadoes upward. It works good against certain enemies, but its slow pace and out of range doesn't make it a weapon you want to use all the time, especially when you're surrounded. Crashman Stage is next. At the beginning, these slow-moving hamburger-shaped pricks pop out of the pipes continuously. The only way to get up these ladders without it being too much of a pain in the ass is the always trusty metal blade. It makes life so much easier. Oh shit, these guys returned from the first game. Remember how they just stood still and were called Mets? Now they have feet and scurry along and they're called Hardhats, a name which would remain throughout the series. Those floating hamburgers come back for this portion when you ride up this platform attached to a track. There are 3 of them, and these guys will make life miserable for you if you don't have the metal blade equipped. Damn, is there any reason why you need any other weapon in this game at all? When you climb this ladder, the Hardhat will be waiting for you to approach him on the second platform. Hop on and hop back off and take him out while he's unprotected. When you get to this ladder split, equip your leaf shield and climb up the right side. Activate the shield when these birds drop their eggs and keep still, letting these little bastards fly right into their death. When you get to the top, slip in here and get the E-Tank. Use item 2 to get back up and over to the ladder on the left, which will lead to an extra life. Crashman can be a pain in the ass. He'll run, jump high, and spit his crash bombs at you, which can hurt you upon contact, or from the explosion afterwards. Plus he can run into you on the way, which of course does damage to you. But fear not if you have the air shooter. 2 shots and he's down for the count. The crash bomber weapon is most useful for tearing down the steel barricaded walls in certain spots. It attaches itself to the wall and then explodes. If you try it against enemies, usually it will just sail right through them. The only thing is, it uses up a decent chunk of weapon energy, so it's not too reliable. Only Heat Man is left. Bust out the metal blades and use them to slice up the prop tops and hamburgers while trying not to fall into the river of flowing liquid fire. The bubble lead works good against these spring pricks, so use it to take out the one at the bottom of this room before you start ascending the appearing and disappearing blocks, in case you fall down. You run into these walls where the appearing blocks will show up alongside it. Use the metal blades to hold off the hamburgers and memorize the timing of the blocks so you know when to jump. and now you'll reach the part where the blocks are most infamous for, by taking you on a trip above the river of flames and a bottomless pit. But it's not really as hard as it is intimidating. You just have to know when a block is going to appear right above your head. There are three of them altogether. The first one appears on the third block from the beginning, the second one appears right above the border of the fire, and the third one appears on the third block after this drop-off. The rest are really linear. But if it's too much for you to handle, whip out item 2 and just sail across. You'll also be able to grab this extra life if you have item 2. The sole reason why we held off on Heatman is because you don't get this item until you beat Airman, but if you can handle the blocks, then you can take Heatman on any time after you defeat Bubble Man. As far as Heatman himself goes, the bubble head is his weakness, as mentioned earlier. He'll shoot 3 blasts of fire that'll become vertical streams. Jump between them and let the bubbles roll. Every time he takes a shot, he'll ignite himself on fire, which will shield off your attacks, and then he'll torpedo across the room in fire form. It only takes a few bubbles to kill him, and you'll obtain both item 1 and Heatman's atomic fire weapon. It fires blasts of flame as expected, but it also can be charged up by holding the B button, giving you an insane shot. But the greater the charge, the greater the decrease in your weapon energy. So all 8 Robot Masters are defeated, and it's on to take down Dr. Wily. This time around, you get a cutscene revealing the Skull Castle and markers to inform how many levels are left. The first stage takes place outside and ends up leading indoors, so this is presumably Mega Man entering the Skull Castle. Use item 3 to ascend the walls and leaf shield or metal blade to rid off the annoying birds. Then you'll run into a few Sniper Joes operating alone here. Use metal blades to take them out from underneath. Oh god, how the hell am I gonna get across this? Well, bust out your trusty item 1 and start a chain of platforms. Just make sure you stand to the edge of them each time so you can reach the ladder. As you run across this area, you'll suddenly be auto-scrolled, and this giant flying fucking dragon pops out of nowhere and chases you down. Once you arrive on this set of platforms, the battle begins. You need balance and awareness here, as you need to jump over his fire attacks without slipping off the platforms. Shoot at his face with the arm cannon to take him out. So moving on to the second Wily stage. At the beginning, launch an item 2 rocket across the field of spikes, and you'll come to a fork in the road where you can grab one of 2 hanging ladders. If you grab the first one, you'll need to use up a few crash bombs to get through these walls and then battle these guys while missing all the power-ups down there. If you take the second ladder, you get 2 E-tanks, 2 extra lives, and a bunch of small weapon capsules. So yeah, take the second ladder, by all means. When these drill things try to tear you apart in this narrow hallway, use the metal blades on them, and you'll probably get a ton of power-ups, so feel free to hang around for a while and fill up on life and weapon energy and possibly some extra lives. Use item 3 to get up this wall, and then use the time stopper to get an easy path through all these metal spikes. You don't need that shit. Now, this boss is very interesting. 2 pieces of the wall will detach and then attach to each other and fly towards you. They do a lot of damage, but the metal blade takes them out in only a couple shots. The tricky part is when the pieces break off the wall, and they sometimes come out of the floor and take you by surprise. The longer the battle goes, the easier it is to predict where the next move is coming from, as there are less pieces left. It's the same pattern every time, so learning its movements will help as well. The third Wily level takes place in what I'm assuming is the rotten bowels of the Skull Castle. The water is putrid and probably gives you cancer upon contact. If Bubble Man saw this, he would be fucking pissed. Well, the stage is very short. The biggest threat throughout is by far the underwater spikes. You have to maneuver between them carefully, and remember to fall to the right side to avoid the spikes on the floor. Before you know it, you're at the boss. A huge fucking tank with an enlarged rendition of Gutsman driving it, conveniently called Gutsdozer. Equip the quick boomerang, stand on the edge of the tank, and fire at his forehead repeatedly. He'll try to fend you off by spitting projectiles in an upward motion or sicking hard hats at you, but the boomerangs will do him in quick, no pun intended.